I'm Doug, your tech support representative here at Atlantic British. In this video, we're going to touch base on an option you have if you're building your engine or doing head gaskets on a 4046. And essentially what it is a replacement set of studs instead of head bolts. Now, you know a lot of the newer engines have the torque to yield head bolts, which you see a lot on now aluminum block, aluminum head engines. You're dealing with a high expansion and contraction rate, which is why you need that style. But you find that if you look, if you see a racing engine torn down, a lot of them will have studs. And the studs are a little bit more secure. They cost a little bit more, but they definitely do a better job. So we're just going to give you a brief rundown on what you would need to do to install the kit. And we do stock for these. That's the ARP 4301. A great kit, comes with the nuts, comes with the studs, and comes with the washers. So we're going to demonstrate this on a nice new block, but you would normally do your prep work, of course, to clean out the silt each hole, make sure the threads are clean, run a chaser down there, make sure they're all clean and lubed. With the studs, though, what you're going to do is instead of putting a dab of oil on that you would normally do on the head bolts, because the studs are inserted and they're going to be stationary, you're going to take just a little dab of thread lock. You can buy these at any parts center. And it just takes one or two drops, and that's, you just want it so it locks the stud in place. Now, you notice the nut is designed to be a 12-point. You would use a 5/8 or a 16-millimeter 12-point socket. You want one and a half-inch drive so that you can torque these down once you get it together. And you'll also notice that you have a coarse thread on one side, fine thread on the other. The coarse thread obviously goes into the block. The fine thread remains up top for the nut. Now, you'll also have six studs that will be longer than these, and they are going to be in the top three center holes. You'll notice that when you take it apart, your head bolts, you're going to have three larger than the rest of them on each side. So make sure you keep note of that when you go to put this together. So essentially, all you're going to nearly need to do, and you can do this one of two ways as far as installing it, you can run a nut down on one of the studs. We'll take a little bit of the, and just say we only need like a little drop. That's all it takes. We'll run the stud into the hole, and we're just going to bottom it out until it comes to the shaft of the stud, so that it'll stop at that point. And you notice I don't even need a driver. In some cases, you may. You don't need to have them real tight. You just need to snug them. And you can do that with either a stud puller or a stud remover, which will slide over the stud and lock down, look like a socket, or just use the socket itself on the nut. And that's all you really need to do, just to lock that in. We'll run the nut out. Let me get a ratchet and we'll put that on there. All right, we've seated this. We'll just grab the shaft of the stud, throw a wrench on there, just break that loose, and we'll spin the nut off. And essentially, that's what you're going to do all the way around. Remember, your three long ones go on top center. Let the thread lock set up just for a little bit. We're going to put our new head gaskets on. And then just something to mention, when you install the head gaskets, you'll notice that there is, one side has steel center between the cylinders where the other side does not. This will be the top of your head gasket, so this would be installed on that direction. Now, a lot of these are also marked. You'll even see it right on the gasket. You can barely, I don't know if you'll see it in the camera, but that does say top right there. If you don't see it, the side that has the most amount of metal, that's the side that goes up. At that point then, we're going to put all the studs in. We're going to show you how to just basically going to torque them in, and you're going to do it in increments. You'll start at 40 pounds, go to 65 pounds, and then final tightening at 85, going in an outward circular pattern. And we'll show you how to do that. All right, so we're at the point now. We've installed all the studs. We have the thread lock in place. I didn't mention earlier, but another method you can use to screw these in is a 3/16 Allen wrench. If you notice on the end of the stud, there's actually an opening there to insert the tool, so you can use these. And all you're going to do is just snug these in place. Once you got them snugged in, the thread lock will hold them in. They're not going to spin out. So we wipe our surface down. We make sure we have no lint. Make sure you use a lint-free rag. Sometimes I find it's better just to run my thumb on that. If you got your fingers on there, it's going to basically wipe any lint or anything that you may have gotten from a rag earlier, because you want this to be a nice, clean, smooth surface. No interference with the gasket. So we've got that in place, and so now we're just going to put the head gasket on, and we'll set the head in place. So we put the gasket in place. Again, a reminder, the side of the gasket with the most metal showing is what's going to face up. I want to make sure the gasket is seated down over the dowel. Take our cylinder head and just a quick check. Want to make sure no lint, no grease, nothing that's going to interfere with the gasket. We'll line up the center stud with the top center. And we just set it right in place. And just slowly work it down. We don't want to drop this or let go of this. We don't want to do any damage to the new head gasket. So that's seated. Now it's just a matter of we're going to put a washer on each stud and then put the nut in and then just snug it. So with all the nuts snug down in place, and I mean just snug, you're going to spin them in until basically hand tight. That's it. And we're going to torque them now in increments. The reason you want to do that is even though they give you a recommended torque spec of 85 foot-pounds, you don't want to sock them right down to 85 pounds. Being it's aluminum, you can cause a little twisting. So you want to start at a lighter amount. Usually I start at about 40 foot-pounds. And what I meant earlier by outward circle, you're going to start on the center bolts and sort of work in a cycling outward circle. You start from the middle and then work both sides and keep working to the outside. Just like you would do heads, manifolds, anything in that nature you're gonna do. So here we have a click type torque wrench. This works really well because then it'll just tell you exactly when you've hit that 40 pounds. We'll run this up. And there's 40. And then we're just going to do that in that pattern I just mentioned. Alright, we'll let it sit for a minute and then we'll turn this up to 65 pounds. And we'll do the same thing. Now once you've done the 65 again, let it sit for a few minutes, let things settle. By that time you set your wrench back up. Now we're going to do 85 pounds, that'll be the final torque. And then we'll put our rockers back on and we'll be all set. And now we've got them all torqued up to 85. Again, did that circular pattern. Now we're going to put the push rods back in. Want to make sure they go down through their guide hole in the head. Just set them all down in place and then we're going to set the rocker assembly back on top. Snug the bolts down in increments because one or two of them are going to have spring tension against them. And then once we've done that, then we're going to torque them to 35 foot-pounds and we'll be all set. Alright, so we've laid the rocker shaft in place. We look at the push rods, make sure they're seated in the rockers. We've done this in small increments so that we've pulled the whole rocker assembly in nice and smooth. I've got a 3/8 drive torque wrench, which the reason I do that is because most of your larger half inch won't go down or are not accurate at a 35 foot-pound reading where the smaller 3/8 drive is. So we'll do the same thing as we did on the head. Basically, we're going to start here, go to this, and go to this, and then one more time down the road just to make sure everything's squarely torqued. All right, so here's the finished product. You can see studs in place, nice neat appearance. Plus the fact is that it's definitely a more secure setup than the torque to yield head bolts. So this is something you might want to recommend, I would recommend that you do if you're doing a head gasket changeover or you're doing an engine rebuild. You want to hold on to this vehicle for a while. This is the route to go. That's really worth the extra money. So when you're ready to do this to your 4.0 or 4.6, just call any of our knowledgeable salesmen at 1-800-533-2210. And thanks for watching.